Don't Mess with My Buddy is the title of a story by Ezekiel J. Kralin that I read in his weblog, zekeblog.wordpress.com. I told him that rather than go through it, he's very prolific. He's written just so much, and I could just look through it for a long time and become frustrated about what should I read and what shouldn't I. So I told him to just send me something every week from his output. You know, it could be new, it could be old, and just something he would like me to read. And this is the thing that he sent me this week. Don't Mess with My Buddy by Ezekiel J. Kralin. Spatiotemporal reader, this little masterpiece of sci-fi parody is dedicated to Stanislaw Lem, born in 1921, died in 2006, whose exquisitely hyperbolic tales of futuristic intrigue eventually drove me insane. It was somewhere in the Crab Nebula that I visited a particular planet as the Milky Way's ambassador and planned to vacation there for approximately 2 months. It was the year 2076. You may be reading my report years before that time because this dispatch has been teleported to key moments in the past, but no earlier than 2017, by which time I had simultaneously become president of Athenia, world's first gay nation, formerly Northern California, and Earth's star spokesperson, thanks to the reptilians of the Andromeda Galaxy, who chose me for such a position because they consider moi the most compassionate sentient being of this world and its galaxy. I co-presided as Athenia's commander with my ultimate soulmate, Larkin Kelsey, who was too preoccupied with dark matter intrigue to accompany me on my journeys through the Crab Nebula. Now, this may seem peculiar to you, as Larkin is highly telepathic and can also travel anywhere in time at the snap of a finger. Yet, in spite of his remarkable abilities, he is compelled to obey the dictates of an even higher force, a force which rules over and contains every aspect of this universe and all the multiverses ad infinitum. For lack of a better term, let's call this force universal mind, and this force so deemed that I must embark upon my journey as sole missionary. The moment I stepped out of the Enterprise version 1.2, the first thing that struck me was the planet's extraordinary sky. Like a rippling zebra skin, black, elongated clouds sailed seductively against a background of light gray firmament, or like the comforter on Leisure Suit Larry's waterbed, if you switch your perspective from up to down. The grand poobah of this world welcomed me with open tentacles and escorted me to all their finest hotels, restaurants, theme parks, media outlets, prostitution clubs, from which I refrained the attainment of full orgasm out of respect for my one true love, 5D entertainment centers, and the average homes of Nebularian residents. I must say here that my greatest delight was visiting these domiciles of average citizens, for their hospitality was beyond any Malibu integral massage therapy I could ever imagine, as it came with the most splendiferous arse-rimming perks. Some days later, the Grand Poobah approached me to offer phenomenal pleasures beyond what I had yet known. He proudly spoke the following declaration, which mesmerized me into such fevered temptation I lost all reason. Sensations many you have great in your world that to heights of ecstasy bring you unbelievable. Yet assure you myself, kind vertebrate, that Nebularians, we can titillate your soul in ways never known before you've. We expose you can to incredible levels such of ecstasy erotic that again never you will return to former enjoyment ways of seeking. Of course, I was greatly seduced to dive right in, considering all the sensual amenities already provided me in barely a week since my arrival, but a tiny alarm bell dinged in my cranium. But there is one man I love so much, I couldn't bear to discover any pleasure that would make our delight in each other fade from my heart. Of course, I met Larkin, whose joy in my friendship is the jealousy of 42,000 galaxies and 574 dimensions, so with all due respect, I will refrain from your magnanimous offer. The Grand Poobah immediately flushed a refulgent pink, but quickly recovered to a sour green. Course of, perfectly comprehend me. Forgive, please, indiscretion, this culture, some differences may never bridged can, and would I dream not broaching social barriers your own. The Poobah promptly vanished, and I found myself escorted to an egg-shaped room by his doppelganger guardians, where I awaited the descent of the Enterprise version 1.8, which Starship beamed me up and returned me to planet Earth in the wink of a Trelfamadorian's orbital socket. war swiftly broke out between Planet Earth's Intergalactic Federation and the Crab Nebula's Union of Soviet Socialist Face-Suckers. In less than 1 week after their initial salvo, the entire Crab Nebula and 18 surrounding galaxies plus four energy-sponging black holes were obliterated into subatomic dust, a piece of wisdom you should all bear in mind. Larkin Kelsey commands the entire fleet of the Andromeda Galaxy. Which reptilians were the first civilization in the entire history of the universe to leave their home planet and terraform all other worlds? Their technology and understanding of universal law far surpasses that of any other sentient life anywhere in the cosmos or any other cosmos. So when you try to turn me against my dragonly heart song, there will be hell to pay. Or I-O-W. Don't mess with my buddy Larkin. A lot of things happened in a short while. There, Ezekiel J. Kralin. And that was in Zeke blog, zekeblog.wordpress.com.